Cathedrals of the Neldergrove. Yeah, sounds like a Lord of the Rings title. This song, I don't even know where to begin with this one. I wrote it with Justin Amadrid, and he was amazing to work with. It was actually the first time we'd ever worked together. And see, this is interesting because there's like certain bits of the story here that I want to share and certain bits I don't want to share. And I'm trying to weigh up exactly what it is I want to say. We got together that day and I was definitely feeling the wit in a lot of respects of things that were happening in my church. And I wanted to kind of, I guess, begin to untangle that internally. And so I get to his house and he's like ready to write. He's like, hey, like, what do you want to work on? I'm like, whatever. And I'm like, yeah. I was like, dude, can we get a coffee? And he was like, yeah, it's cool. I'll make a coffee in the kitchen. And I was like, nah, I was like, can we go somewhere and like sit for a second? He's like, yeah, sure. So we went to, I can't remember where it was, like some cool place in East Nashville. And we sat and I just kind of started like talking to him. And we ended up having this really good sort of like healthy conversation where we're talking about church and the beautiful things about it and the challenges with it and the areas in which we've been hurt or seen friends hurt and all of these kind of things. And I think we talked a lot about the transition that the church as a whole was kind of going through and the reckoning that was kind of happening, especially in the evangelical church. And so we went back to his house and this song just kind of like poured out in a lot of respects. Now, we did some editing after the fact, and in all honesty, the initial version of the song was a little rawer and perhaps a little bit more pointed or sharp, that would be the way to say it. Because I guess I was feeling a little raw. I think with a little bit of space and hindsight, I was able to like, I guess soften the edges through wisdom, as opposed to, when something happens, like if I want to have a fight with my wife, I'll say things in the moment that I mean in the moment, but in retrospect, I probably don't mean with the same harshness or articulation as I would say them in that moment. While they're entirely true in the moment, they're not true over the course of the month to follow. And I feel like that's what happened with that song. I kind of went in and had a fight with my wife. And then a month later was kind of like, okay, I still think there's problems here, but with a bit of space, I can see maybe better how we approach them. So there was a little bit of editing we did, and I'm really grateful actually that we did that. And the song to me, I've really danced around at this point what the song is saying, and I don't know if I feel like I can articulate it as well as the song does. So I feel like if you go through and read the lyrics, you go through and listen to what's actually being said, I think you'll get it pretty obviously or clearly. One of the things that a cool story that I do have, and one of the things that I think is really beautiful about how this all came together was, there was a song I wrote a few years ago called Seasons, which was very much based on the idea of sequoias. And it was all about how sequoias, it was all about sequoias and their seed. And the biggest tree in the world. They live for 2,000 plus years. Like, they're incredible, incredible trees. And I've always been, really since a kid when I first saw them, I've always been inspired by them. And I wrote that song, and at the time I was teaching in college in Sydney, and a student came up to me and was like, and gave me a sequoia seed, which is this beautiful present that I still have. Kind of looks like an acorn. And they said to me, do you know how sequoias reproduce? And I was like, no. They were like, well, they actually need fire in order to reproduce and spread their seed. And my mind was absolutely blown, because I just written this song about sequoias in winter, And yet I find out maybe the coolest thing about sequoias is in the summer. And so I was like, I need to write another sequoia song, but that feels like a pretty weird thing to like double dip on. So in the back of my mind, I've been just thinking for a while, like, when am I gonna like be able to talk about sequoias again? When am I gonna talk about sequoias? And it kind of just came to me as we were sitting, kind of tying up this song, like what's the piece? And we wrote that last verse about the sequoias and how maybe, just maybe, they serve, sequoias, for all the good they bring to the world, like, and they provide shelter for birds, and like there's a lot of good things they're doing. Perhaps they serve the most in their demise, like in their death, because it's once they're under the soil that they actually start feeding and nourishing the other sequoias. It's when they leave the room and the space, the other sequoias can grow taller, and you've got this sequoia that once was perhaps bigger than them all, feeding them from below. And I think that's a really beautiful, maybe metaphor for a lot of things. And I think, I went and researched that. So I remembered in the session, this student in college that had given me the sequoia seed. And I had this flashback memory of it, and I was like, I just want to double check that's true before I really start writing about this. And so I Googled it, and up came this video from Chad, the ecologist, and it maybe has like 500 views on YouTube. I found it, and he's just talking about sequoias and how they grow, which is that audio sample that you hear at the very end of Cathedrals. And I heard it, and I just could not believe what I was hearing. It almost felt like he, on the back of the song, which had already been written, he was just speaking this like life message on the back of something that felt quite sort of like depressing is the wrong word, like hopeless almost. It was like, this is the situation. And then I hear this guy just talking about sequoias, like not trying to make any sort of statement, he's not preaching a message. But to me, it felt like that. Like, it felt like there was so much in what he was saying, that it just fit so perfectly. So we find his email, and I emailed him and asked him if I could use his voice. And he graciously said yes. So I'm proud of how it all came together. I'm glad we did it. Honestly, I was umming and ahhing. I didn't know if I wanted to release this song. I didn't know. I've always said that I wanted the record to be an overshare. And I didn't know if this was just pushing that a little bit too far, but I'm really glad I did it, because I think it seems to have really connected with a lot of people that maybe have found themselves just in funny situations with their respective churches or on the fringes. And one of the things I wanted to do with this record was reach out to the people on the fringes, because I kind of felt like somebody, ironically, while I'm very much in the middle of something, I felt simultaneously on the fringes. Like, there's the line in Faith Is, it's like, I'm not a lost sheep, I just feel alone in the flock. And this song was for those people, the ones that feel alone in the flock. Like, they're still there, they're still hanging on by a thread. But it's like, I wanted to talk about some of these things so that maybe they'd feel a little less crazy in their feelings and doubts and denials and whatever it was. So yeah. And at the very end, it says, you can't change where you've been, but you at least have where you are. Every start has its end, but every end has a start. And while there's death, while sequoias grow tall and they do eventually die, the beautiful thing about the circle of life, the renewing, is that there's more. There's always, like, in that original, like, and when I finally see my tree in the original seasons, I still believe there's a season to come. Like, there's still more beyond the arrival. Or there's still more before an ending or a death. Sorry, I rambled a lot on this one. And maybe I didn't even talk about it at all, but I hope that was somewhat helpful. This is Cathedrals with an Elder Group.